لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله ما لنا رب سوى
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله سيد الأنبياء وخاتم المرسلين Brothers and sisters in Islam, respective viewers, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh and ahlan wa sahlan and welcome to our program. First of all, we make a special dua. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala accept the hajj of our hujjaj. May Allah grant them hajj mabrur wa sa'y mashkur wa amal mutaqabbala, and may Allah save guard them and the entire ummah inshallah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, once again we welcome you to our program. I'd like to thank all our brothers for the comment, phone calls. Shukran jazilan. We have a special thanks to all our friends who's watching our program from Johannesburg. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for all your effort. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward each and every hafiz al-Quran for teaching the hifz. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for our young ulama to complete their courses so that inshallah they can take the lead of the ulama and the ummah, inshallah, guide us to hidayah and tariqul jannah, inshallah. Ameen, thumma ameen. Last program, I was talking about the protection in Allah from some thought of diseases in this dunya, physical diseases or spiritual diseases. So you remember when we talk about isti'adha and seeking protection in Allah from some thought of evil. Why I'm saying that? Because you alone, as a human being, you're unable to defend yourself and protect yourself. So you need a superpower. You need a helper. And the only one who can deal with this one, according to the Kitab of Allah, isti'adha, or the hadith of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is only Allah. That's why we say a'udhu billah. On other program, we did say a'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim, min al-jinnati, wa a'udhu rabbil falaq. We did read some isti'adha. And I'm telling you, the only one who can help you from that, it's Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. No one else. Don't look for the black magic or jadu or the other sihr. I'm telling you, Allahu ghaib wa ilajuhu ghaib. Allah is unseen, and that sickness and disease is unseen. So we need Allah to come and interfere and protect us. So Allah khayru hafizan wa huwa arhamur rahimin. We continue with that sickness, and that problem can irritate us in our life and thereafter in Akhirah. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made a long and special dua. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min ghalabati ad-dayn. I seek protection in you from that sickness of debt, to be on debt. You know better than me. Some country lost the power because of financial problem, because of the debt. Ghalabatu ad-dayn, we got, all of us, we owe Allah. All of us, we owe Allah. And we need you to forgive me from something, we owe it to you. And if you look at in the day of Qiyamah, it's called Yawmuddin. Many ulama said it's not deen is religion, deen is dayn, that debt. When you owe people and you started to exchanging the rights and debt, to paying and to you get depositing and withdrawing in the day of Qiyamah. So Malik Yawmuddin, deen is like debt. Because in the day of Qiyamah, there's no da'wah day, there's no deen and ibadah, it's just paying, receiving, and getting. We got debt, you can manage it. Like many business people, they owe this company and the company owe them his money is on the market. So that one they call it dainun yutaq, manageable debt. And we got duyun la tutaq, and some debt, impossible to survive with it. They have disgrace, can face people, also that is, can take it, can manage it. Police run after you, bank run after you, they want to arrest you, stress, depression. You're unable to manage your business or to your life. People are run after you. Hammun bil layl wa khizyun bin nahar. Stress at night, disgrace on the daytime. People stop going for masjid because the debtor or the people who owe them money is there. That's why we said Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam refused to read Salatul Janaza on that person who owe people money, even if he's shaheed, even if he died for the sake of Allah. First thing Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked before he read the Salatul Janaza, is this man madiyun? You got dain? This dain here. Does he owe people money? He said, no, I'm not reading salah on him. He's in a problem. If he doesn't fulfill and pay that debt here, what about the debt of Akhirah? So we Muslim, we have to sort out that debt. You know, we got some debt, we have to pay it. Some debt we have to make istighfar for it, like speak bad about you, reconciliation and some sort of intercession. But I'm talking about physical one. Physical one, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min ghalabati dayn. In dunya and akhirah. In akhirah also is a problem. The name of Allah on the day of Qiyamah is a dayan. The judge and prosecutor and the one who take you to task for that. And do you need dunya? The materialistic dunya must be solved here, not on that side. Between you and Allah we can talk, but between you and the abd and the servant of Allah, you have to fix it here. That's why this is a nice sunnah. This is a nice sunnah to stand up in the time of janaza of the mayyit, your father, your friend, or anyone, any Muslim. And he said, if this marhum or that deceased owe people anything, family is ready to pay. It's big favor for this person. Now he can go free. But to leave him with a death like that, what about the death? We got the death of dunya and death of Allah. The payment of Allah on the day of Qiyamah is big problem. So, seek protection of Allah from ghalabatuddin. Wa qahri rijal. Qahri rijal means overtaking or overpower men. What is that? A person, a man like me and you, father of the family, leader or big man, unable to protect himself and his family from the evil of the other. And it's very hard for a husband unable to protect his wife or from that man on the street he wants to do something or offending her or his children. Or he can't stand as a man to have that dignity and honor to protect himself and to stand up for his right. That is called Qahrul Rijal. Qahrul Rijal also, all your family stand against you. That is hard. That is very hard. The entire family boycott one man. Like a mafia. That is, you call it Jafa'ul Aqarib, a relative. And how come whole family against one man? It's unfair fight that. Unfair. The whole country run after one man. The whole country with the army and police run after. That is right. Wa shamatatul a'da. And the happiness of my enemy when you see me in calamity. You know, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, لا تظهر الشماتة في أخيك قد يعافيه الله ويبتليك. Do not show off do not show the pleasure and happiness of the calamity of someone else. Because Allah is able to save him and put you in the same thing. And it happened. I did see it in my life. His daughter ran away with a boy. Oh, you know, the show of piety is good. It's good. Then that problem comes to this house. It happened. Typically on that family. You see, we don't want to show a pleasure and happiness on the calamity of someone else. You know, because once the opposite, your enemy got calamity, supposed to soften your heart. You got a problem with your next door. Then, mommy, the crooks came and they beat our auntie and took everything next door. You say, yeah, it's good. Yeah, hawla wa quwwata illa billah. not supposed to say, Allah, I got a problem with her, but I don't wish for her to have that ending or that punishment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clean our heart and purify our heart from that jealous and hasad, inshallah. Short break, we'll talk with more, inshallah, after break. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brother and sister in Islam. You know, I want to tell you one secret. All my sound engineer and my cameraman, they like that one. And they enjoy the topic today. I said, alhamdulillah, I'm very happy that they are listening to me. Don't want to mention their names because they don't want me to mention their names. So what I'm trying to say now, Allahumma inna a'udhu bika min qahri rijal. Qahri rijal will find a man. You got the dignity, you got the manhood, that honor. Then you find him crying like a small baby on the street, or disrespected from his family, or at work, or in his company, or with his friend. He's unable to feed his family, protect his wife. You got that ghira and this. Or you find a broken heart man. Got very, you know, the dangerous sickness and disease, they call it depression and stress. Never, doesn't want to smile, doesn't want to laugh. He lost his ruh, piece of bones, on a remaining man on the family. That is not a man anymore. And then, Allah min a'udhu bika min qahri rijal, when the man is unable to do his duty on bed. That one, he become inactive or does not active on bed. That is hard. That is hard also. That's right. Or neglected man. Neglected man is, you know, that why Nabi Muhammad said, you must look after our elderly people. Because those who are in pension, retired, the former minister, former police, you know, these people who got authority. Hey, if you don't keep them busy, they got that depression and they got a lot of stress. They die slowly, these people. So Islam say, uplift them. Irhamu aziza qawmin dhal. You must have mercy for the one who had authority, then he lost it. It's very hard. It's very hard. So a person become unable or disabled, who got some disability mentally or physically or financially, and while he's there on his feet. It's very, very difficult to see a person like that, because you compare him with this condition and that other condition. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in this case here, we give him zakat to bring him back to normal, back to his status back. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min zawali ni'matik. That one is very important. Especially our women, our sisters in Islam, he said, I seek protection, Allah, from a removing of the ni'mah, the bounty, to take away the bounty from me. Knowledge, beauty, wealth, health, children, status, your wife, you know, it's very difficult. You know, when the divorcee women, very angry before divorce, my husband doesn't treat me well, not, I want to get rid of him, then give her the talaq, which I don't recommend ever a Muslim to utter this word talaq ever. Then the lady took her bags and stuff and go sit alone and become a divorcee woman, and she said, why did I make a mistake? And then she lost that crown or that umbrella on top of her. And the man as well, they asked the man, why are you crying after you divorce your wife? He said, Kana jannati fa kharajtu minha. She was my heaven, and I walk away from it. And he said, marry another one. He said, no, if I chop my finger, if I put a golden finger after it, or replace it with a golden finger, it will never be the same. And ask those who divorce and got it. Every insan got khair. You got talent, you got ni'mat from Allah. That is a wife, children, job, wealth, health, authority. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min zawali ni'matik. Wa tahawwulu afiyatik. And this tahawwulu afiyatik, it means you leave me alone with the means, only means, asbab. We know Muslim, rely on means, the cause. You plant, then you get the crops. But we Muslim believe above this means, there is a causa. It's Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. So when you leave Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, all right, I leave you with the means and deal with the means. That's why Muslim always keep yaqeen that the blessing and the barakah and the care of Allah help us. But the disbeliever, you see, no, they rely on medical aid, what you call the insurance, that all that physical means. Then when they don't come right with that physical means, they gone. Us, we have the causa. We have Allah tabarak wa ta'ala da musabib. So now you said, Ya Allah, Ya Allah. I said, no, don't say Ya Allah. You got a nice, clever doctor there in the hospital. He said, no, I need to go to doctor. It's asbab, means. But I need the causa, the creator of the asbab to do it. Because Allah is the one who got full control of asbab. How many farmers, they say the crops this year, mashallah, seed is very lovely farm. Doesn't want to say it. Qarun, why we go far? Qarun, he said, no, I got it because of my knowledge, my asbab. Then Allah said, فَخَسَفْنَا بِهِ وَبِدَارِهِ الْأَرْضِ. Now I left him for asbab. Enjoy your asbab, then he gone. No, the business like that, the, what you call the currency, the stock exchange, you know, these people rely on too much on expectation, but they don't say, Ya Rab. You say, all right, we'll see now. My farm is going to have produce this, crops, but then he never expect that these waves of heat, or the birds, or the insects, or the sickness, or the cold, or whatever, these asbab day. So, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min tahawwul afiyatik. Allah leave you alone with that thing, and then you are suffering. Then, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min jami'i sakhatik. Oh Allah, I seek protection in you from all your anger. Sakhat, it means the wrath of Allah, or the anger of Allah, or the curse of Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala. Imagine, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save me and you, that Allah is not happy with you. And then your boss is happy, your father is happy, prophet is happy. No. We need Allah. رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه. So that's why if you still remember our program, we're talking about the curse. Be careful to be cursed by Allah. So la'natullahi alal, and then you find it there. We did say it on the program. So if Allah have wrath on you or curse you, who's going to help? Who's else upon Allah? Now the ulama said, how you get that one? We don't know. Allah, inna Allah akhfa thalath fi thalath. Allah hide three on three. Ridahu fi ta'atih. His pleasure on any type of obedience. Any good deeds can let you gain the pleasure of Allah. And wasakhatahu fi ma'asiyatih. And his wrath and anger on any type of disobedience. Any type. Don't talk now about major sin, minor sin. We don't know because Allah hide it. He can get you anyway, brother. And says that's why we said stop disregard or underestimate the sin because it's hard. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam seek protection Allah from hamazatush shayateen. Wa a'udhu bika rabbi an yahdurun. I seek protection Allah from instigating of shayateen al-ins and jinn. You know the shaitan al-ins wal jinn. وَعُوذُ بِكَ رَبِّي أَنْ يَحْضُرُونَ. And I seek protection in Allah that they attend that deal. We make أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ when we read Quran. Because if you don't make isti'adha, we'll interrupt you. For salah, Allahu Akbar, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ. So when shaitan make nazgh, snatching you, instigating, pushing you, deviating you from that ibadah, you have to say, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. وأعوذ بك ربي أن يحضرون. And I seek protection Allah that they must not attend that deal. In the time of nikah, shaitan is there. Time of food, shaitan is there. Time of jima, the sexual intercourse, with your wife or husband is there, when your partnership is there, when you do any good deeds, the shaitan is there. So you ask Allah, Ya Allah, chase away. And the shaitan is also hidden, unseen. How are you going to chase him? You need Allah to take it away. So shaitan can be present in your ibadah, in your hajj, in your dhikr, in your zakat, sadaqah. They will interfere. So you say, Allahumma inna a'udhu bika min hamazat ash-shayatin wa a'udhu bika rabbi an yahdurun. Right. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min azab al-qabr. I seek protection in Allah from the punishment of the grave. Brother and sister in Islam, we Muslim believe that there is punishment on the grave. Azab al-qabr haqq. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Jibreel alayhi salam, came with so many information about the punishment on the grave, till Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came out from his room, uncovered head, his face is yellow, and then called Bilal radiallahu anhu to give adhan and called the ummah and tell them, Ista'idhu billahi min azab al-qabr. Seek protection Allah from the punishment of the grave. Ya Rasulullah, he said, yes, there is punishment in the grave. And the incident and the story is a lot. Is not our, we don't have time for it now. But I'm telling you, Sayyidina Uthman ibn Affan, when they mention for him the punishment of Jahannam, he doesn't cry. But when he mention the punishment of life on the grave, he cries. So they ask him, why you leave that one? And he said, this is the first experience of Akhirah. The last step of dunya, first step of akhirah, they call it barzakh. And azab al-qabr haqq, animal hear it. And Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if I was not, lawla an la tadafanu, lada'awtu Allah an yusmi'akum min azab al-qabr. If it was not my fear and worry that you will never bury your beloved one, I would have allowed, oh, I ask Allah to let you hear some of the punishment. If you heard what is happening in the grave, you will never bury your beloved one day. You leave him outside. So, animal heard it. Nabi Muhammad was passing the grave. Then the mule jumped. He said, for who this one? For these two graves. He said, it's for one man and woman. That man here, he كان لا يستنزه من بوله. He was not hiding himself when he was relieving himself, urinating. Oh, some ulama say doesn't wash properly, or he doesn't hide. Like the people we see them on the highway or on the school, they relieving in front of each other. And the other lady, she used to gossip and backbite and spy next door. So it's not about kufur and jahannam and kufar and disbelief. It's about something you think is a small. That's why I tell you, be careful. Be careful, there is a punishment on the grave. So, استعيذوا بالله من عذاب القبر. First, عذاب القبر is to be alone there. First punishment of the grave is to be alone. And then, the other punishment of the grave is called ضمّة القبر, is the embracing or the squeezing of the grave. Nabi Muhammad, when he buried his daughter, he was crying a lot. Then he smiled after that. So they ask him, why are you crying and smiling? He said, I remember that I was thinking that my daughter, she's too slim, she can't take the hug of the grave or the embracing of the grave or the squeeze of the grave. But Allah told me, no, she will be saved. We'll give her the mommy's hug. It's like a soft one. So what about me and you? That's why I say, Adab al-Qabr, it's terrible, because the first experience of the punishment of Allah. Some people now, in our time now, they don't want to walk in a grave, just from outside. And they say bad spirit, bad what, I don't know what you call it in South Africa, you got a ghost. Outside, we're still alive. What about when you go there? And it's Laylatun Subha, Ya Allah, Laylatun Subha Yawm Al-Qiyamah. One night is a night. Only you'll get that dawn and that morning in the day of judgment. Too long. And then darkness. So you need to save ourselves from Adhabul Qabr. And to be alone day is another punishment day. Right. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, seek protection Allah from su'ul hisab. What is su'ul hisab? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us. I'm not frightening you. I'm just reading it with you. Maybe this thing is going to affect our heart and we can make some plan to avoid that. Inshallah, Allah will protect all of us from that. Inshallah. Short break. We'll continue after the break. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brother and sister in Islam. Once again, we say shukran jazilan for your comment and for your feedback and your phone calls. And shukran jazilan that you always tune into our ITV. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from any fitna. Oh Allah, come closer to us to prevent us and to protect us from any evil in this dunya and a grave and an akhirah, inshallah. We still continue with the isti'adha, seeking protection in Allah, not in someone else. Don't go for sihr, jinn. No, we need Allah. Because the only one who can solve it is Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala. In Allah, we seek protection in Allah from su'ul hisab. What is hisab? You got hisab in dunya. And then when you owe people money and try to work it out that, and have a look at it, and you get surprised, you say, from where you got this one? No, I never buy this. No, I don't know. I paid you. Lot of confusion. That's why they write it down, they record, they put slip. You got too much proof for that. And then with that, when you calculate and you try to fix your account, you find a big surprise there. You never thought about it. So what is the su'ul hisab on the grave on akhirah? When Allah tabarak wa ta'ala take you to task for small and big things and never ever overlook one mistake. You know, we have hisaba yasira, easy. You know, when father and son, they calculating the account, they say, okay, leave that one. I took you for lunch. No, don't put it. I gave your son this hadiah. I say, no, don't put it. You remember that birthday where I give you that? No, don't put it. This is called flexibility on hisab, easy hisab. So that's called hisaba yasir. Some people enter Jannah bighayri hisab. There's no hisab at all. No, man, it's fine. Oh, it's happy. When you owe people money and then you say, go. Oh, you feel happy. Allah will release them from that pain and of hisab on the day of qiyamah. You just say, khalas. Alhamdulillah. Hisab financially, or maybe hisab when you apologize to someone and say, no, it's okay, go. Or just to relieve. They see the brazen when they come out from the brazen. Lovely. Now, su'ul hisab, Allah count every mistake, small or big, never ever left it. That is called su'ul hisab. Especially those who reach the age of 40. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when the person reached the age of 40, then Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is telling the malaika, ashduda wa daqiqa. Fasten your book properly and write neatly. Don't release one sin. Write it down. For those who reach the age of 40. May Allah grant us hisaba yasira. May Allah make it easy, inshallah. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, seek protection in Allah from harrun nar, the heat of Jahannam. To see Jahannam is a problem. What about if to enter? You got different type of names of Jahannam. You got Ladha, you got Sa'ir, you got Hutama, you got Hawiya, you got Ghashiya, you got Nar. You got too many names of the fire of Jahannam. And in our life now, just see how the people get burnt. Or that fire on the company. See the fear and the horror on those people who get burned. That is not Nar al-Akhirah. This is a Nar al-Dunya. That's why Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, La yu'adhibu bin Nar illa Rabb al-Nar. He saw someone just putting a living being or insects in the fire of Jahannam. He said, no. And they want to burn someone. He said, no. We as a human being, we're not allowed to punish with fire because Only Allah, the one who punishes with fire, not anyone else. So you see the our children, when they get insects, mosquito, some bird or something, throw it in the fire, it's a big crime. We don't allow, teach the children, only the one who punished with nar, fire, it's Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala. So, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min harrin nar. Don't want even, not the heat of Jahannam, I don't want to see Jahannam even. Take me from the other entrance. Some people don't like to hear someone else to suffer. You know, like some people don't like to go hospital. We ask him, I say, no, I can't take that situation there, they are screaming. I said, no, you get reward and learn. And some people say, no, I don't want to see the face of the mayit, the deceased, right? It's hurting me. You say, okay, it's good, but you need his command of Allah to have there, maybe you can slow down. So they harrun nar. Then Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he pick up this one. He said in Quran, قُلْ أَعُوذُ رَبِّ الْفَلَقِ مِنْ شَرِّ مَا خَلَقَ. What is شَرِّ مَا خَلَقَ? If خَلَق is creature, whatever he created. So he created water and ice, and he created trees, fish, what else? Plenty creature around, all kingdoms. For each and every creature, evil and good. So you don't need to name it now. So for everything, that car you're driving, you got khair and shar. Khair to take you to masjid to read salah, for hajj, umrah, to visit people. And shar to take you to nightclub and haram, or to kill you. So that's called min sharri ma khalaq. So when you enter the empty house or dark room or something, you read قُلْ أَعُوذُ رَبِّ الْفَلَقِ مِنْ شَرِّ مَا خَلَقِ. What? It can be jinn, shaitan, whatever. Right. Then, وَمِنْ شَرِّ غَاسِقٍ إِذَا وَقَمْ. From the darkness, when it becomes dark. It's really, why the night is scary? Why when you don't want to enter the dark room? Because the creature there become invisible. You don't see them, you don't know where the harm will come. Harm from jinn, from a human being who's hiding there. That's why the robbery, the crooks, they start at night. Because it's darkness, it's scary. Right. وَمِنْ شَرِّ النَّفَّاثَاتِ فِي الْعُقَدِ. What is that? They talk about the black magic, or they talk about sihr, or those who blow on the knots. It's not our topic today, but this one here is a separate, because we have to talk about evil of the jinn and the sihr. Many people, they're scared of jinn more than Allah, or they worry too much that someone is going to make jado or what you call sihr or black magic, or you call it South Africa, witchcraft or sangoma, and people say being killed because of people's things, or that type of naffathat if locked. All right. Many of the ulama, they spoke about that and said, once you get Allah next to you, even if you believe that this person is black magic or whatever, will never harm you. The child is under the care of his father. The children will never harm him. No way. That's why your children are very confident in front of in your yard. And you tell your child, I'm here in a garden or in a park. Play next to me. Take your bike and ride here. If you go far, there's some problem. So the child listen to you, play around you, and you keep an eye on him, alhamdulillah. You go home nicely, bike is there, not hurt. Your son left you and ride his park and go his bicycle and go far. Now the boys met him there and then hit him, abuse him, took his bike, come here, broken, bleeding. So the father told him, I told you, let's play around here. Move around here so that we can pick you up, can protect you. Insan, Muslims like that. When you do ibadah, you come closer to Allah, you're under this umbrella. You run away from ibadah, you don't need Allah, you go far from Allah. Not only jinn will harm you, your own wife will harm you. Your own son will hurt you. So play on the yard. Now you will be under the protection of Allah. So we making 5 times salah, wudu, isti'adha, reading Quran, no jinn, no creature, no khalaq, no creature of Allah can come and harm you. Nafathati fil uqad, whatever day. Why? Because I'm under the umbrella of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. So fala khawfun alayhim wa lahum yahzanun. So they ask Sayyidina al-Hasan al-Basri, do you know jinn and shaitan? He said, no, I don't know. Doesn't harm me. They know how to deal. Sayyidina Umar al-Khattab was not jinn. He was a human being. But the jinn and shayateen avoided him. Took another road. A human, Allah, I'm in a hurry to go to Akhirah to meet Sayyidina Umar al-Khattab. Two Sahaba, I'm very, very proud of them. I want to meet these two people. Inshallah, Allah write for all of us to meet the Sahaba in Jannah. Umar ibn al-Khattab, I want to know that man, the jinn used to get scared of him. What type of man this? And Sayyidina Uthman ibn Affan, Malaika, feel shy to look at him. So much dignity till the angels feel shy to look at him. And to have that dignity, too much honor on his face. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accompany all of us with the Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Akhirah, inshallah. Short break, we'll continue after the break.
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله ما لنا رب سوى
لا إله